Blessed are we when we are sincere in our heart, when we tell the truth, when we focus on God, because we will then see God. Blessed are we when we are makers. Makers, not just prayers. Makers and work for peace. That's what we act like we are. Children of God. All of us gathered here, we're baptized. We are called to be different because we follow Christ. And we will not allow the world's events to define who we are. We will not allow the world's events to take away the hope in us. Because of God's love, we are changed, and we are continually calling to change this world with love. Even if others do not understand it, share it, or just don't find it. We have it. We must live it. Because following Jesus demands a change in us. From being spectators, as I said, worship is not a spectator sport. We are called to be agents of praise, and agents of inspiration, and agents of hope, and agents of love, agents of change that will change our world, change this country, bring us together in unity. Because you see, love does have power. It's not just a sentiment. It conquers hate, it conquers anger, and it will conquer the fear among us. In this rite of confirmation and reception, in the middle of our busy lives on this beautiful day, each one of us here gathered because these people have decided to be confirmed, received, and reaffirmed their baptism. Because they are doing this and we are here, we have the opportunity to join with them and renew ourselves. Renew our souls, our hearts, and our minds. To recommit ourselves to our baptism. Yes, yeah, time to walk away, but today we can reclaim it. Our baptisms are more fundamental to our soul's health than any pledge, any idea of national identity or citizenship, no matter where you come from and where you're going. When we have compassion, love, truth, strength, and courage to renew ourselves to God, we become, as Abraham Lincoln said, the better angels of our nation. So, my brothers and sisters, all of you who are gathered here, we get to chat and start over again, thank God. We get to be new again today. You want to feel new, or do you want to stay old? Hello? You want to get new? Let's do it. Let's embrace life and time in a new way and enter into Christ. Agents of that love, to act in word and deed the love of God, to find and serve God everyone, even as we were served by the homeless, we must serve others. We can work for justice and not fairness. We can work to give respect to every human being, no matter where they are from, no matter how they came into this country. They are still a precious child of God. We can care for this child. Practice what we say and pray, and what we better see here. We need to do this for our own soul's sake, but also for the soul of this country. And I think we adults need to start following the youth. Let them do this to eradicate military assault weapons among civilians. Today, we get to start all the folks. Get to be and embrace God's love and blessing, the very power of love, and then embrace it with others. To change this world and the times in which we live in, we need love to change a stranger to become a friend. We need it to change the hate and anger, resentment and fear. It is time for us to renew ourselves to the world of God's love. Not to stand by as spectators frozen by fear. It's time to believe in him too. In the words that song of homeless wanted to sing, we are the ones who will make a brighter day. So let's start living. Oh, there's a choice we're making. for saving our own lives. It's true. We'll make a better day. Just you and me. We are the world. We are the children of God. We are the ones who will make a brighter day. So let's start doing it.